طيب let's talk about as I mentioned some points from this book يعني about the أذكار because this is very important. Okay, some points about the أذكار. عليكم السلام. طيب he mentioned this point about the أذكار and I mentioned this before and this is very common mistake. The أذكار يعني some people confused or they mix أذكار صباح المساء and أذكار الفجر والمغرب. Okay, the أذكار after the فجر and مغرب. Okay, this is not exactly like the أذكار الصباح والمساء, morning and evening. Different. طيب, why? Because when we say أذكار الفجر والمغرب, it means after the صلاة. After the صلاة. And when we say أذكار الصباح والمساء, the morning and evening, of course, morning means فجر. So it can be before صلاة الفجر. Evening or afternoon, different opinions. There is an opinion after it is from الظهر, another opinion it is from العصر, third opinion it is from المغرب. So they are not the same, not the same. So this is one point. The point that I or he mentioned here that repeating the three quls three times in many masajid. Okay, the paper here. Okay, the wallpaper it is written. After the salah you recite قل هو الله أحد قل أعوذ برب الفلق قل أعوذ برب الناس. Then in between brackets what you'll find three times after مغرب and فجر. But this is not authentic. This is not authentic. This is very common. طيب, but I notice in some masajid it is not there. الحمد لله. يعني this note it is not there. Okay, so reading قل هو الله أحد قل أعوذ برب الفلق قل أعوذ برب الناس after فجر and مغرب it is the same like the other salah فجر ظهر عصر مغرب عشاء one time you read them but as أذكار صباح and مساء three times. Okay, تمام. This is yes, this is different. This إن شاء الله will come to this. طيب also, يعني you know, sometimes the author mentions something, يعني different opinions. يعني for example, اللهم أجرني من النار. اللهم أجرني من النار. Okay, يعني he mentioned it is not authentic to say اللهم أجرني من النار seven times. Oh Allah, protect me from the hellfire. You repeat this dua seven times after Maghrib and after Fajr. He said this is not authentic. You can say this dua anytime seven times. But other scholars said it is authentic to repeat this seven times. Okay, you know sometimes it is different opinions. Also, there is يعني something that people in some countries when I'm traveling. Okay, yeah, for example, now I'm sitting with you, we are having the coffee. Why? Because I'm traveling. I'm going to the airport, or maybe I'm in the airport. You drop me at the airport, and so what they end their conversation. Yeah, for example, if I'm traveling, I say, لا إله إلا الله. And you reply, محمد رسول الله. عليه الصلاة والسلام. Okay, this is not sunnah. This is not sunnah. But I don't know, this may be not common in your culture, صح? Okay, الحمد لله. الحمد لله. الحمد لله. الحمد لله. Every country, they have their own bid'ah. Okay?
We have different
bid'ah. Yes, different bid'ah. So في أمان, the point is, okay, you say في أمان الله. The point is when people practice something as a sunnah and they ignore the sunnah. لا إله إلا الله, then the person, محمد رسول الله عليه الصلاة والسلام. Okay, why you are saying this? Okay, الله أعلم why they are saying it. Okay, nice to say لا إله إلا الله, nice. No doubt. But to deal with this kind of dhikr as a sunnah, this is the problem. This is one point. And the other point, you'll find people practicing this يعني this way and they are ignoring the sunnah. The sunnah is استودعك الله دينك وأمانتك وخواتيم عملك. Inshallah we'll come to this point. And you reply استودعك الله الذي لا تضيع ودائعه. So people follow bid'ah or they follow something not sunnah and they ignore the sunnah. So the point, this is not sunnah. And also one of the يعني mistakes when يعني when we read Fatiha and the Salah, for example, you notice some people إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. So you hear him استعنا بالله. Okay, also not come in your culture?
No.
Alhamdulillah, so not everything, not all the bid'ah from your culture, right? Alhamdulillah.
We have enough
bid'ah,
so no need.
Enough bid'ah, Allah musta'an. I remember this old, يعني, maybe for 35 years, I remember, يعني, when old man, when he's praying, يعني, subhanAllah, a lot of noise. A lot of noise. Many adhkar. Okay, يعني, also before saying Ameen, he's saying something. Yes, when the Imam says, وَلَضَّلِّي, he says, رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْ, Ameen. يعني, so this is not sunnah. This is not sunnah to say استعنا بالله. Also, there is an issue, as I said, this is what, يعني, some of the issues controversial about the القنوت في الفجر. To say the دعاء قنوت in every فجر صلاة. Okay? And this is common in Shafi'i and maybe Maliki. But it is not authentic hadith. And we have something to clarify. It is not authentic. When Abu Malik al-Ashja'i رضي الله عنه said يعني he was asked by his son, you prayed behind Abu Bakr, sorry, you prayed behind the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, okay, أكانوا يقنطون, okay, they were doing قنوت, they used to do قنوت in الفجر صلاة. He said, oh son, this is bid'ah, this is innovation, this is innovation. طيب, so والله أعلم, يعني the most or the stronger opinion that no need to make the قنوت in the فجر. Yes.
Sheikh, the قنوت is basically before ركوع, but we have seen in Kuwait mostly it is after the ركوع.
The قنوت, okay, number one, what is the meaning of قنوت here in this topic? We mean by is the قنوت to make the دعاء in the صلاة before or after the ركوع. Before or after the ركوع. Okay, so we have a hadith that the Prophet ﷺ was doing the قنوت after the ركوع, and there is a hadith he did the قنوت before the ركوع, or يعني the قنوت before the ركوع. So both of them are there in the sunnah. طيب, as Sheikh Al-Albani رحمه الله mentioned, he said if you are doing the قنوت in the نوازل, in the فرض salah, it is after the ركوع. But if you are doing this in the witr, it is before the ركوع. If it is the نوازل after the ركوع, if it is in the witr, before the ركوع.
انت
زي he mentioned that there are hadith that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did the قنوت. What does it mean قنوت? The دعاء in the صلاة before or after ركوع. طيب, so Sheikh Al-Mai رحمه الله mentioned as a collection from the hadith, he said, if you are in the first salah, Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, and the Imam is going to do the qunut to make dua for some Muslims, or to make the dua against the kuffar, or some of the kuffar, the qunut should be after the ruku'. Sami Allahu liman hamida, Rabbana wa laka alhamd. Allahumma alayka bifulan, alayka bifulan. But if you are doing this in witr, okay, so you do the qunut before the ruku', okay, and يعني there is a narration like I think from the tabi'in, okay, يعني for example you are reading the Fatiha, then قل هو الله أحد, الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد, الله أكبر, اللهم هدينا في من هديت وعافينا في من عافيت, you make the dua, then another الله أكبر, and you go to the ruku'. طيب, so for the witr, but يعني many scholars said even in the witr you do it after the ruku'. Even the water, you do it after the ruku'. So, but yeah, no problem. If you do it after ruku', no problem, inshallah. Yes, it is common here in Kuwait that we do the ruku', the qunut in Ramadan for the water after the ruku'. Okay? We are doing this after, يعني, for me, I did not see any imam who's doing this before the ruku'. But I think someone told me that there is a masjid or something they are doing before ruku', صح? Okay, I remember maybe one of the brothers told me, طيب. So this is the meaning of the qunut. Also, one of the issues about the adhkar, when you finish the recitation of the Quran, you say صدق الله العظيم. At all, this is not from the Sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and this is very common. They practicing of many Muslims. طيب and the problem we hear this from the radio, the TV, from the famous قراء. The famous قراء are not a proof. The proof from Quran and authentic Sunnah. We take our religion from the Quran and authentic Sunnah, يعني from what the scholars mention as references for us, شريعة. Okay, يعني you know sometimes people say, no, no, I hear this in the radio. Saudi Arabia radio, Kuwait Quran radio. It is not a proof. It is not a proof. Okay, to end your recitation with صدق الله العظيم. طيب, what should I say if صدق الله العظيم not Sunnah? Don't say anything. خلاص, don't say anything. الحمد لله. يعني we have the famous hadith when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told Ibn Mas'ud رضي الله تعالى to recite Quran. So Ibn Mas'ud رضي الله تعالى started to recite some ayat from Surah An-Nisa. Then Ibn Mas'ud said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told me, حسبك. يعني it is enough. خلاص حسبك. Stop here. It is enough. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did not tell Ibn Mas'ud, say صدق الله العظيم. He did not say. خلاص حسبك. That's it. طيب, and you'll find many ahadith that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned ayat without saying صدق الله العظيم. Yeah, for example, when the companions رضي الله تعالى يعني like confused or they were wondering or some يعني or they were asking for as clarification. الذين آمنوا ولم يلبسوا إيمانهم بظلم أولئك لهم الأمن وهم مهتدون. They said, يا رسول الله أيون لم يظلم نفسه. Okay, Allah mentioned ظلم here. So all of us, يعني we wrong ourselves. So we cannot get the benefit of this, the virtue of this ayah. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, you did not hear the other ayah, what the wise man said. يا بني لا تشرك بالله إن الشرك لظلم عظيم. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned the ayah and he did not say صدق الله العظيم. Okay, so no need to say صدق الله العظيم. No need to say صدق الله العظيم. Right? So the problem يعني in the school, they teach our children صدق الله العظيم. خلاص. And our children take this from the school. خلاص in the school for 4 years, 5 years, 10 years. صدق الله العظيم. خلاص. And radio, TV everywhere. And the famous قراء. Yeah, and the problem, as I said, if he's famous, it doesn't mean he's correct. Yeah, nowadays, in the YouTube, the famous Qurra, how many mistakes they do? How many mistakes they do? Okay, in the way of their reciting, yes, mashallah, their voice, very nice, their tajweed, very nice. But you notice mistakes, or sometimes you don't notice the mistakes. Look, this. The viewers, 2-3 millions, 5 millions. Okay, this is the famous Qurra. يعني, he's reciting the Quran in a way, mixing. Is it the way of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم reciting the Quran? Jazakallah. Okay, it is not the way of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. طيب, also to add after the ruku, I think we mentioned this, but no problem to repeat this. After the ruku, سمع الله لمن حمده, ربنا لك الحمد. والشكر. So adding والشكر, it is not sunnah. It is not sunnah to add والشكر. The dua after the ركوع, ربنا ولك الحمد. Or ربنا لك الحمد. Or اللهم ربنا لك الحمد. If you like, حمدا كثيرا طيب مباركا فيه. طيب, or the other dua. But to add the word الشكر. So you notice, subhanAllah, sometimes people, they like to add. Okay, nice words. But it is not sunnah. Yeah, for example, the tahiyyat, inshallah, we'll come to this point. اللهم صلي على محمد, اللهم صلي على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم. Okay, why you are adding سيدنا؟ محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, he's our سيدنا. You don't respect him, we respect him, we love him. But he doesn't like this way. He doesn't like this way to add the word سيدنا. طيب, it is not in the hadith. It is not in the dua. طيب, so try to avoid, your best to avoid what is not mentioned in the hadith. And يعني also one of the يعني أذكار or دعاء, the imam says before we start the salah, صلي صلاة مودع. Pray as you are leaving the dunya. طيب, الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله said, لم يرد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه كان يقول للناس عند تسوية الصفوف صلوا صلاة مودع. The Prophet, الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله said, it is not nothing came from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he was saying when he was telling people to stay straight line. He did not say صلوا صلاة مودع, pray as you are leaving the dunya مودع. بل كان يأمرهم أن يستووا وأن يقيموا صفوفهم ويبين لهم أن تسوية الصف من تمام الصلاة. But he was telling them straighten your line, okay, and يعني perfect your lines. وأما صلوا صلاة مودع فلم ترد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام, ولكن وردت عن بعض العلماء فيما كتبوا أنه ينبغي الإنسان أن يتقن صلاته حتى كأنه يصلي صلاة مودع. But what he said, Sheikh Muhtamin Rahimullah, it came from some scholars, they wrote that it is recommended for the Muslim when he prays, okay, to bear in mind that when you pray as if it is the last salah, as if you are leaving the dunya. Yeah, they are telling us, the scholars, they are not to say this before we start the salah. And also, yes, there is a hadith. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to one of the companions, صلي صلاة مودع. Okay? Pray as you are leaving the dunya. But the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did not tell him, before starting the salah, he told someone, صلي صلاة مودع. No, it was a general nasiha. Maybe they were chatting together and he gave him this nasiha. So the sunnah, if you are the imam, okay, before starting the salah, okay, you check their lines. سد الخلل, okay, try to straighten your line, you closed any gap, طيب, but not to say صلي صلاة مودع, طيب. And also there is a bid'ah to say الصلاة خير من النوم in other than الفجر. This is only for الفجر, only for الفجر. الصلاة خير من النوم, طيب. Also, one of the points that he mentioned that no one from the scholars, from the Salaf, the great scholars, said that it is sunnah or it is recommended for the start of the year or the end of the year, there is a specific ibadah. Okay, the end of the year, the start of the year, there is number of rak'at you have to pray, there is a dua you have to say, nothing from the Salaf, nothing from the scholars. طيب والله, we are waiting the end of the year, yalla, we send the end of the year, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for my sins, and nothing. Or at the beginning of the year, we ask Allah to make this year as a new year for us, nice year with health, with wealth, with this. Nothing from the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Sheikh, in Haram we hear that Imam says Sami Allahi Man Hamida, somebody else says on the mic, Allahumma Rabbana Lakal Hamd. There are some masajid in Kuwait also, they follow this pattern during Ramadan. Is it okay, it's coming from sunnah, somebody actually making other people say Allahumma Rabbana Lakal Hamd, and then these people, they miss saying Sami Allahi Man Hamida?
Asking brother about for example the Haram, also in Kuwait some massages, yes, they do like this. طيب, the imam says Sami' Allah liman hamida, then there is maybe the muaddin with mic also, he's saying loudly with his mic Rabbana lakal hamd. طيب, there is something that tabligh what the imam is saying. Wasn't it tabligh to convey? If the voice of the imam is not enough, okay, then we can help him. Someone can help him. Yani for example, if there is a big crowd and there is no mic, so maybe I am here, طيب, and at the end of the door, okay, because there is another group praying, طيب, I say Allah Akbar. He's saying Allah Akbar because they cannot hear. Okay, and difficult, they cannot see the imam, but they can see the end of the lines. So I say Allahu Akbar, he says Allahu Akbar. I say Assalamu Alaikum Rahmatullah, he says Assalamu Alaikum Rahmatullah. This is okay if it is needed.
But there's a mic and a speaker everywhere.
Well, I choose, sometimes even in the haram, maybe you notice the takbir of the imam not clear. Like that, maybe he's going down and he's saying the takbir. Not clear, not all of them,
طيب we say it, but if it is not needed خلاص we should not do that. We should not do that. And also here in Kuwait, يعني what is the need? Because you know, in the masjid, all of them can see the imam or who is behind the imam. If they are, for example, you know, sometimes they pray outside the masjid, like Masjid al-Kabir, the Grand Mosque, Kuwait City. Maybe not nowadays, but if you remember before 25 years, especially 27 night, okay, more crowd, maybe 10,000 inside, 20,000 outside. Okay, so maybe it is needed. Maybe it is needed. But if there is no need, even the microphone, يعني in the masjid, يعني now we are in the masjid. Okay, how many people in the masjid praying Fajr? 7-8 people. So, no need for the mic. Switch off the mic. Why? Alhamdulillah. So you, the imam, he likes, and you notice some of the masajid, the amplifier in front of the imam. He likes to hear himself, يعني he wants the environment, يعني like in the studio. يعني no need for that. We are 6-7 people. Okay, I switch on the mic. And of course, al-Fajr Salah, no women. What is the point? No need, Habibi, يعني save the electricity, save. Okay, now you know the problem, يعني people, they like the other things too much. The echo and these things, why? Subhanallah. So, يعني sorry, maybe some people say, no, this is for the Quran to me. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was enjoying the recitation of Ibn Mas'ud. How? Quran and echo and nothing like that. صح? But he was enjoying the qira'ah. And also Abu Musa al-Ash'ari. لقد أوتيت مزمارا من مزامير آل داود. Okay, when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم heard the recitation of Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, Abdullah ibn Qais, his name is Abdullah ibn Qais رضي الله تعالى عنه. Okay, he said, you are given mizmar. You know mizmar is a kind of instrument, musical instrument. من مزامير آل داود. Of course, this doesn't mean this is a permission for music. No, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم wants to describe that his voice, mashallah, nice, very nice. طيب, so you should be careful, يعني don't focus on the dunya, okay, and or the issues, and you must, you know, because you know sometimes because of the echo and because of you miss the meaning, you miss the meaning of the qira'ah. You are focusing on the voice of the imam, okay, like singing the Quran, يعني, and you are missing the meaning. الله المستعان. طيب. So nothing for the new year, the end of the year, nothing, no need for that. He mentioned there is no specific surah for Salatul Duha. No specific surah for Salatul Duha. You pray your Duha, and you recite anything, any surah from the Quran. Okay, so these are some points.